Welcome back to another video. My name is Adam from WPCrafter.com, where I make videos for non-techies like me. And in this video, I'm going to show you a new way, with the quotes, the air quotes, a new way to add custom CSS to your WordPress-based website. You see, just a short while ago, a new version of WordPress was released, version 4.7, and they made it super duper easy in this new WordPress release. I just wanted to show you, it is pretty awesome what they've done. Now, there's lots of ways to add custom CSS to your website. First of all, you can add custom plugins to do it. Sometimes your theme might have a special area to do that, or you can always just go ahead and directly add it to the style.css file in your theme, or if you had a child theme, you could do it that way as well. However, this new way is just so much easier and it's visual, and I just want to show you how to do it in this video. And I think moving forward, if anyone ever asks you, like a theme developer or someone says, put this custom CSS in your website, this is absolutely how you're going to want to do it. All right, so I'm going to log into a demo site that I have set up, and it has a fresh installation of the latest version of WordPress, version 4.7, and they added some new features. They added a whole bunch of new things to WordPress 4.7, but the one I'm talking about is going to be in the customizer. So to add custom CSS, you would log into your WordPress website, go to appearance, and then customizer, and it takes you here. Now, this is the new 2017 theme that was just released with this new release of WordPress itself, and they've got a new option here in the customizer. It says additional CSS. And so when you click on it, you can go ahead and put whatever CSS, just copy and paste it right in there. Now, I do have videos on using custom CSS and how to find things and make those fine-tuned little tweaks that you're going to want on your website. So what I want to do is show you how easy it is to get rid of the site's tagline or site description. And so here I have it right there, site description, and these are the properties for it. And I'm going to go ahead and remove those. So say I wanted to make it disappear entirely. Well, what you would do is you would type in the class, which is site description, and you would type display like that, and then you would type none. And then you'd go like that. So, like that. And that's all you'd have to do to apply CSS. Now, here's what's awesome about this. If you noticed, as soon as I put the entry in, it immediately reflected on the website. And so what that means is now you can make your CSS edits and see them in real time. Now, some of my done-for-you templates, I was waiting to release because I wanted you to have this functionality. I have one on creating online courses, and what I wanted to do was make it very easy visually to change the colors of certain properties in the learning management system that weren't, there's no like set setting. So anyways, this is the way I am going to be modifying CSS moving forward. It is pretty awesome. There's a lot of new features in WordPress 4.7. I'm really enjoying it, but I just wanted to get this info out to you on how to add custom CSS to your WordPress website, the new way of doing it. Hey, before you go, I have something for you. And before I get into that, I wanted to ask you to do something for me. If you could give me a thumbs up on this video. And if you're not a subscriber, click on the subscribe button right beneath me. If you have a question on this video, I'd be happy to answer it. You can also leave a comment or a question down below this video. Hey, I put together a course just for you, and I'm going to give it to you for free. All you have to do is click on the button right here on the right. It's called the 3-Step to WordPress Success. It's an awesome course. You're gonna love it. I would love for you to join in and enroll as a student in this course. Thanks for watching this video. I really appreciate it, and I do it just for you.